Marabu have released 20 new colors of Easy Marble and they've landed in our warehouse. In today's video, I'll show you the new metallic colors, both Color Shift and the traditional ones. I'll show you the Color Shift glitters, the neons, and the regular opaque pigments. We've been offering Easy Marble on sale at 30% off, and that's going to continue and will include these 20 new colors. As I want to do, I'm going to start at the beginning, and for a release of 20 new colors, let's talk about them and talk about the varieties of them. So within this group, there are 5 pigment-based ones that are opaque and you will need to shake them. They are gray, gray-blue, lilac, mistletoe, and taupe. There are 4 neons, which are transparent, so neon green, orange, pink, and yellow. There are what I think of as 4 traditional metallic colors, which are also opaque and also need to be shaken, so antique silver, copper, rose gold, and white pearl. And now comes the good stuff, the Color Shift metallics and glitters. The thing to know about them is that they're pretty unassuming looking in the bottle, but they're really cool on black and dark surfaces. So the metallic Color Shifts are blue gold green, green red gold, green violet silver, and teal silver red. The Color Shift glitter colors are blue green gold, green red gold, and violet blue green. Now happily, the bottles are well marked. You can see that there are names on the top of the bottles and there are numbers, and we'll have them posted up on the website with the numbers, so that'll help making the correlation also. Easy Marble is a solvent-based product and it has an odor. So open a window, run a fan, do whatever it is that you feel you need to do to help dissipate that odor. Let's talk about what can get in the way of success with Easy Marble. The 2 most important factors to your success are the water and how you apply the product to it. So let's start with the water. And what factors there are the temperature and what might be in it. I have a well and we have particularly hard water here in my part of Rhode Island, so I always use distilled water instead. The minerals that are dissolved in my water play havoc with it. I just eliminate that potential problem by using distilled water. The other part of this that's critical is the temperature of the water. It should be in about the 72 to 75 degree range. Too hot or too cold is going to shorten the working time. Because Easy Marble is a solvent base, your work time under optimal conditions is probably between 1.5 minutes and at the outside 3 minutes. So you don't want to do anything that kind of shortens that already fairly short window. When it comes to applying the product to the water, the thing to pay attention to is that whatever your first color is, it should cover the entire surface. So keep that in mind when you choose the container to put your Easy Marble in, or you're going to Easy Marble with. So let me slide this out of the way and bring in my container, and you can see that it is well used. I have been working with it. So because I'm working with paper only, I don't need anything particularly deep because paper isn't particularly thick. If I were working with something 3D, I would want a container deep enough so that I could submerge the piece into it. Now, the thing to bear in mind is that because you have to take that first color and really cover the entire surface of the water, if your thing is this big, you don't want it in a container this big. Otherwise, you're using product, or you're adding product to the surface of the water that you'll never use. So to start with, I have 2 colors. I have black, which is one of the original colors, and I have the Color Shift glitter that is violet blue green. Now, the thing to know about this is that the colors can really stick on the bottle, on the bottom rather, of the bottle. So this piece right here will come out. All you have to do is just grab it with a fingernail and take it out. You'll notice I'm wearing gloves. I generally do with Easy Marble. So I'm going to stick, and if I kind of hold this up, see all the stuff in the bottom of the bottle there just below the label, and there's really none circulating in the liquid. I'm going to get this up off the bottom, and it's particularly noticeable with the metallic colors, whether they're the Color Shift metallics or the traditional metallics. You really have to work a little bit more to get that the pigment that's in the bottom up and moving. So with that said, now I'm just going to go ahead and give this a shake. Let's slide this back in. So I'm going to shake this. Since I think I'm going to put this down first rather than the black first. That's what I've done recently, and let's just try something different. Now again, you can see that this is just kind of like white liquid, but you'll have to trust me when I tell you that it's there. And be generous, because this first layer is going to impact everything that you do and is a great part, along with the temperature of the water and using distilled water if necessary. It has a great deal to do with your success or lack thereof. So I'm going to put some black on here. And I know that you can just see, because I can see in the monitor, I can see that there's, you can just see the kind of iridescent color. Now I'm going to take a toothpick and I'm going to stretch it through here. So I need some more black. That's definitely not enough. Now, one of the things that you'll notice when I bring the toothpick back out is that the color is being manipulated, but I'm not gathering great big hunks of it on the toothpick. And that matters, because if I were, it would mean that this had already started to do its thing. So let's go ahead. I'm going to put this is, well, that's not going to work. Let's get one that doesn't have black on it already. This is a piece of our whites. Good grief. All right, so trying again. This is a piece of our white smooth and sturdy. I'm going to put it in on an angle like this and let the color roll right over the top. Now what I need to do is slide this away so that, if I could get it to slide away, there we go, so that I don't pick up color on the way out. So you can see that that doesn't look particularly remarkable, but when the light hits it just right, you can really see the color shift metallic or color shift glitter in the background. So now let's do this with some black. Now you're thinking, well, that's black on black, and what's it going to do? Well, what it's going to do is not allow the color shift in certain areas. And what I am going to do now is take this off. Now, ordinarily, I could probably get another dip out of this, but I want to talk a little bit about black on black, and it's kind of pertinent. So what I'm going to do is bring in a couple of samples that I made. So this is black. Let me think of what this is. This is one of the opaque colors on just black, and I didn't put anything else with it. Sorry, I know the glare is making it a little bit difficult to see. But you can see that for the most part, the black that's on there is dull. Well, that's because the black smooth and sturdy is not shiny. When you look at this one, conversely, see the areas of black where there's light reflecting? That's because I used black easy marble, so you get a completely different look. So don't assume that you can't use black easy marble on black stock, because you absolutely can. So when you have all of this stuff that you're working with, and now let me slip my gloves back on, because there's enough left in there, and I don't think I've been talking too much, but there's enough left in there that I might be able to get one more, what I think of as a print. So I'm just going to lay, well, what do we got here? Let's get something that's not a mess. I'm just going to lay this face down over here and see what happens. Okay, so there really was enough left on there to get it. And you can kind of see the color shift on there. Now, obviously, this is a little bit more dramatic when you're talking about working on a black or a darker surface. Up next, I'm going to bring in the neons, because I think that they're fun and they're bright and they're cheery. A couple of other things to know about Easy Marble are that it's multi-surface, so it can be used on things other than paper, like I'm doing today. Fabric is one, although it is not wash safe when you use it on fabric. You can use it on glass, you can use it on plastic. I've seen it used on styrofoam. For today, I'm going to stick with paper, and for this next demo, I'm going to use the four neon colors. But what I want to show you is that obviously there's some stuff left from this last time, and you can see how it's kind of skinned over. That is an indicator that it is definitely not ready to be marbled with any longer. It needs to be cleaned off of there. So you kind of have to find a piece of scrap paper or something to just know that you're going to use for this purpose to pick up anything that's left. Now, I'm not doing a real good job. I'm just trying to get this out of the way, but I did want to show you that this is the process. You obviously want to start with a reasonably clean surface. So you'll have to kind of, as I said, sacrifice some paper to this. All right, that looks better. It's a little bit hard sometimes to see the color shifts because they are so light, but you'll kind of get the hang of that. So because Easy Marble doesn't really blend, what I can do is use all of these colors together, and I'm not going to get a muddy mess. So I'm going to put some of each of the neons on, and I'm going to start with orange as my base color just because it's the first one I picked up. So that's the one I'm going to put the most of out so that I have, again, that surface is colored, or covered rather, sorry. Get some of the yellow in there. Now these are transparent, so though I could put them on black, I'm not going to get very good results because you won't see the color. It's just going to look like black. So with that said, let's just go ahead and throw these on here. I'm going to bring in some of our watercolor tags and I'll print on those. Now nothing says I have to do anything to this. If I want to just come in and push this under here and pick up the pattern as it is, I can certainly do that. And you can see, whoops, sorry, glare again. Good grief, let's hold it this way. So there's orange, and you didn't see too much of the pink, a little bit down there, some green. The yellow and the green are kind of close. I think I'm going to add a little bit more pink because I want some pink. And this time I am going to use a toothpick to distribute the color a little bit. And you know what? Just for fun, let's throw a little bit of the rose gold in because we can. Or actually, is this rose gold? No, this is copper, but that's all right because that works with the warm neon colors. So we'll just put a little bit of copper in there to see what kind of havoc we can wreak. And grab another toothpick and then start moving this around. And again, your clue here that I'm still in a workable state is that I'm not picking up sheets of hard or solidified easy marble. It's simply coming up, or it's simply being moved by the toothpick. So you can see here, I missed, but that's all right. I mean, for the sake of demonstration. So you can see I've got that really cool patterning going on. And again, I can continue to work with this as long as there's color on the surface and as long as not enough time has elapsed to get this to the point where it's solidified to the point where I can't print it. So for this last one, I think I'm just going to lay that down like that. And this time I actually got more of the rose gold. I kind of like that. Actually, I like that a lot. I don't kind of like it. So let's see if I can grab another one. I wasn't going to, but what the heck, right? All right, so that worked out pretty well too. So again, there's options. You can slide it in on an angle, or you can just kind of plop it face down and see what happens. So with that said, whoops, let's grab my sacrificial piece of paper here again and go ahead and clean what's on the surface off. And then the last thing I'm going to show you today is one of the color shifts, and I'm going to use one of the new opaque colors. It's just a standard color. It's not a fancy-dancy one or anything, but it's named Lilac, and it's actually quite pretty. Wipe my fingers off here. And I'm going to use the Lilac as my base color. So, again, Lilac. Now, I lost my glitter color. Here it is. All right, so I have, this is the color shift Metallic Teal Silver Red. Remember I mentioned that, let's slide this back over here, and there's just a mess. My bottles are a hot mess, my work area is a hot mess. You can tell I'm into it because there's stuff everywhere. All right, as I mentioned when I was stirring the glitter color, the metallics tend to be, they seem to settle a little bit more, and the pigment seems to be a little bit, well, I know it doesn't seem to be, it is a little bit finer. You can tell by looking at it that the particles in the glitter colors are a little bit larger, so you'll have to take that shaker top out and give it a good stir. Now, I think I'm going to use Lilac as my base color, and just to save time, I'm going to do the same thing, and I'm going to stir the Lilac that way too, just to make certain. Yeah, I can feel that there's nothing in the bottom there, so that's good. The color's up. All right, let's wipe my fingers so I'm not in too big a mess here. All right, I know that this is ready to go. So on the top goes the Lilac. Now see how it's not hitting right there? That's because there's actually color left on there. So that, while not fortunate for this particular demonstration, is worth showing you because you want to clean that up because the color is not going to behave the way that you expect it to. So let me find another piece of sacrificial kind of paper here and see what we have. I think I got most of that up, so let's go ahead. Yeah, see now the color is spreading, except for right there, but at this point I'm not going to fight it. So now I've got color on there, and I continue to be a bigger hot mess every second that I go here, but that's all right, sometimes it goes that way. And I'm going to shake up my metallic color shift and go ahead and put it on. Now this time I'm going to use black, and because the Lilac is opaque, I'm going to be able to see it. And of course I'll also get the color in the color shift. All right. That. All right, so here comes a piece of black, and I'm going to do the plop thing. Well, that wasn't exactly what I meant to do, but that was kind of what I was trying to do. All right, wow. So there's my plop. Lots of really dense color. It's hard to see because it's wet, but I've got the effect of the color shift from the metallic. Let's go ahead and print on white. Ooh, that's pretty too. You got, again, the variations in the Lilac. Again, I have very wet, sticky fingers. So now, what else can we bring in? Because now I'm kind of on a roll here. Let's bring in some of the rose taupe. You know what? That's not... Well, that's all right. It's not metallic. I guess we can live with the fact that it's not metallic, and we'll just kind of see what happens here. All right. Stir this up. Now I'm getting close here. See how that's starting to do that? In fact, it is almost... Well, it is really beyond the point of what I should probably use, but... I am forever doing things I'm not supposed to. There's no reason to stop now. Okay, so I'm probably not going to go any further with this particular application just because I can tell that I'm at the point where I've gotten about as much out of this as I'm going to. So, 20 new colors of Marabu Easy Marble available now and on sale at 30% off. Grab what you like. We can work with all kinds of different fun things here, and I think you're really going to have a good time with it.